We don't play the social game. We are social. Power 98.5.
Can you hear it?
What's good?
Hey, what's up, peoples?
What up?
How are you guys doing?
We haven't seen you guys in quite some time.
Yeah.
But we are back.
2 weeks and better than ever.
I think it was like three. We were running on three.
Oh, yeah.
Time flies. We want to apologize for anybody that listens to us on a weekly basis. We'll explain throughout the episode why we were MIA for the last few weeks. But thank you for joining us. This is episode, I don't even know what episode we're on. What is this, 41?
I want to say 41, yeah. 41.
So this is episode 41 of the Terrible Reception Radio Show.
Slow.
Slash podcast.
We are radio sloshed.
And like always, head over to the YouTube. Like, subscribe, turn on that bell notification. That way you get a notification every time we drop a video. Head over to Apple Podcasts, leave a review, leave a rating, makes us look good, pushes up in the rankings, and also go to Spotify, head over to the podcast section, search for the Terrible Reception Radio, and just follow the podcast.
Yeah. When you guys leave comments or just like the video or show us any attention, we go from old Kylie to new Kylie.
Yes.
So
a much more attractive Kylie.
If you guys could get a visual for it, that's what we're aiming for.
Basically. And
you don't have to be who you always were. That's the thing.
Mm-hmm. So it's like there's this Batman skit, like a parody. I don't know if you've ever seen it. It's like this weird version of Batman. He's just like super slow. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
No,
I think it was like on Funny or Die or something like that, but he's like really slow. And there's this one where he's like with Superman.
Yeah.
And Superman, when he puts his glasses, Batman goes, "Oh my God, where'd he go?" And then he takes it off. He goes, "Oh, there you are."
I think we need like a side pilot of just that show in general.
That's so fucking funny.
That sounds good.
What was I going to say? What were we just talking about? Oh, yeah. So, yeah, it makes us look better. Not that it makes us look better, but, it makes the algorithm, pushes us through the algorithm. And obviously, the more engagement we have on any of those pages, the more likely we are going to be in front of new listeners, which is basically what we want.
People stay at hotels off of ratings, right?
Right.
So, just take that into consideration.
You get into an Uber driver's car because of
ratings.
Right? Yeah. What else? You watch a movie sometimes because of the IMDb rating or Rotten Tomatoes percentage.
Exactly.
So, same thing. So, if you see a podcast that has a rating of a 4.5 or a 5 or I don't know, whatever your liking is, but you're more likely to listen to it. And also, it'll be more likely for somebody to put us in front of other people because they're like, okay, they have this backing. They have a large engagement. Yeah. Large audience engaging with their content. So, hey, let's put them in front of more people to see if we could make some money off of them.
Why not?
So, yeah, man. So, we here.
All right.
Episode 41.
You guys are now tuned in to Ronnie Flonnie.
Haven't done this in a while.
And Chet Michaels.
My name is Chet Michaels, and it gets triggered every time this weird song comes on.
I love it.
Been a little rusty, but
yeah, I just yeah, I just a while. That gets us in the vibes. So.
It does. But one day we're gonna sit down and put some new sounds into this thing.
We have to,
but we're gonna leave that one in there. That was one of my favorites.
That's Mr. Tummy Giggles right there.
Tummy Giggles. That sounds like a terrible porn name.
Yeah, right.
A guy with a huge penis.
Chet Michaels left his set way back from the Terrible Recession, and he became Mr. Tummy Giggles.
I got a weird visual of that. I just picture somebody with like a huge penis, right?
Yeah.
The balls as the eyes and just flip it upside down and there's like a tattoo across the person's chest going this way.
Oh my God.
It's just a smile.
And that's like your profile picture?
That's it.
Jesus.
The Pornhub, your OnlyFans profile.
Maybe you're having deja vu. Times are going to get rough, bro.
Oh man. Yeah. Hey, whatever. It is what it is. I do want to tell you that I was speaking to somebody that's in the military. Her name is Kat. I think you remember her as Jotty.
Yes.
Johnny the Bonnie.
Johnny the Bonnie. How is she?
She's good. She's running a fitness program with Chachi. You know Chachi? She's pretty popular in the Jersey area. She's
Chachi, if you're listening, I'm pretty mad at you. You unfollowed me for no reason. We knew you back from the day of the classics.
Yo, word. But they're running like this fitness program. And I posted something about like the Fort Hood station in Texas that found another person dead.
Oh, man.
And she commented on it and I asked her if she would be willing to be on the show.
Okay.
Just to speak on, you know, just the military and the just the process of everything and why people are, you know, fearful of reporting certain things. So
that'd be awesome.
Maybe we'll have her on, or trying to see if we could get maybe one or two other people on there just so we could have different perspectives. I'm actually trying to find somebody that's actually experienced something of that nature.
Okay.
Maybe like an assault of some kind or some kind of harassment or something.
Unfortunately, somebody that was a victim of.
Right. Yeah. So just to get some insight on that topic, because I've been super interested in that lately. So maybe that could be one of our first call-ins. So.
Let's do it.
So, you know, that's something that I was talking about this weekend.
Okay.
I guess we could jump right into single check. I don't have many topics to talk about today. So is that what we're going for?
I don't know. I tried.
No. Yeah, I guess that goes.
Signal check.
Let's do that one more time.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's go on to the next segment.
Signal check. I like that.
I like it. It's cool.
It's delightful.
We'll polish it out a little bit. But signal check for anybody that is a first-time listener. This is where we check in with each other for the week. Since we haven't been here in a couple weeks, we should have a bunch of stuff to talk about.
Oh, hell yeah.
So we check in with each other mental health-wise or just health-wise in general, just to see where we are in the week.
Cool. You want to go first? You always usually let me go first, so...
Yeah, I guess I could go first.
We'll switch it off weekly.
Let's see. So I've been okay lately. Mm-hmm. I've been feeling a lot of anxiety lately because I've been overwhelmed with work.
Mm.
Just trying to keep up with clients, doing shoots, you know, the turnaround, and then getting back into the flow of my other job.
Yeah.
Seeing the kids and stuff like that. So it's just a transition. It's not that the job is difficult at all. It's just, you know, just transitioning back.
Because you want to make everybody happy. That's the hardest part.
Right. So
I saw a kid at like, you know, that ice cream spot that I like,
mm-hmm.
Bucket and Bay.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like freaking out. He's like, oh my God, the line is so long. And I had to remind him. I was like, listen, bro, I know we all deal with like a little bit of anxiety and like, but it's like, you got this. You're in control.
Mm-hmm.
They want the ice cream. So you take your time.
Mm-hmm.
You do it right. We all got you.
That's it.
And if they complain, you're still in control. You run this bitch. And then he was nice. It's good to like let people know in society that you're not the only one.
Yet. Right. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people, when they get into that I guess the pit of anxiety or depression, they kind of feel like they're isolating themselves,
mm-hmm.
and they're kind of alone. So it's sometimes something as simple as, listen, I go through it too. You know, let's talk about it type of thing. Or, hey, I see you type of thing, you know? So, you know, like I said, I've been super overwhelmed with just trying to keep up with clients. I think I did my last gig for the next couple weeks.
Yeah.
So I got some time this week and maybe half of next week to catch up with a bunch of edits. So I'm almost done with Wesley's video, which is the boxing video.
Shout out to Wesley Fit.
Shout out to Wesley Fit. We exchanged service for service.
What's up with these flies? I think I have too many fucking plants.
I'm trying to get drunk.
I'm not hating on it.
Can't be mad at that.
Nope.
Let me see. Outside of that, no.
What's a positivo?
Positive is I had a lot of gigs this month.
I wish we had like a dollar bill sign, like ching.
We could do. No.
Yes, there you go.
Okay. I had a lot of gigs this month.
Yes.
As a duo and individually. So that, like, I always tell everybody when they're like, oh, how are you doing? And I was like, I had a lot of gigs this month. It's a good problem to have, you know, just trying to catch up and stuff like that. So
what I liked about this month is, like, I had a lot of gigs I was excited to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
That was the difference. You know what I'm saying?
Speaking of which, I did a baby shower for somebody that I've known for half of her life, basically.
Isn't that like always an honor?
Yeah. And she sent me a video of her flipping through the pages of the photo op that she made of the photos. And then later that night, she went into labor.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
That was nuts.
Maybe it's like some type of like endorphin release where it's like the baby's like, I'm comfortable to come in the world. My mom is happy.
My picture is good.
My picture is good. We got this out the way.
Yeah, that's it. Let's go.
You know what? It's so weird. I feel like the human body, I've seen it with death too. Mm-hmm. Like I feel like certain people, it could be parents, like hold on for their parent. Like they wait for somebody that they want to see before they pass away. Or like, I don't know. It could be something like that where it's just.
Maybe.
I don't think it's too out of the
I've seen it happen before. I know exactly what you're talking about. So let me see. I guess that was a positive.
That is definitely a positive. Congratulations.
Angelica.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm trying to think. I know we've been gone for some time, but it's always like one of those things where it's like you feel like you have so much information in your head, you just draw a blank.
It's funny because like I think like we touch base on what we're doing. Mm-hmm. So it's like we're rehabbing for the public. Mm-hmm. We're like, hey.
Like the conversations we've had anyway.
Exactly.
Sometimes it's like that, yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's it for me. No. Overall, I've been good. I've been trying to take some time just to wind down. I try to keep the weekends like to myself.
Yeah.
Even if it's just one of the 2 days. Just so I can, you know, just do self-care stuff.
Yeah.
I don't know, go on a picnic or go for a walk. I don't know, go swimming. I don't know.
Where have you been going on picnics? That's a nice area.
Overpeck Park, Bergen County.
It's where you find Mr. Tummy Giggles.
That's where you found those damn skunks that were bothering us the other day.
Oh, shoot, I saw that.
It was so fucking weird.
Skunk almost sprayed me the other night.
Yeah.
It came out the bush, like right near the apartment building above mine. Mm-hmm. It was just like, oh, fuck, I don't need this tonight. I don't want to take a tomato. Yeah, I was like, I don't want a tomato juice bath right now, please.
Yeah, we were just chilling at the park, and literally the thing just started trotting up to us, like, hey, what's up?
Basically, skunks, porcupines, they're all cute, but then you're like, you're deadly.
It was mad fucking cute.
Not deadly, but you know,
it was super tiny. And then the whole time we were there, it just like got as close to people as they could possibly get without feeling uncomfortable. And we were trying not to startle it, so it could be like, hey,
I know, your ass.
So it's kind of like, you know, just keeping it a safe distance. He's like, he wasn't trying to bother anybody.
Right.
So then he leaves us and then goes over to the other side of the area that we were at. And then he got into the people, there was like four girls, and he got into their food.
Oh,
so
no.
By the time they noticed, he was already like knee deep in their food. So,
you know what? It's sad. Like if I had to make like a cartoon about a skunk, it's like his whole life is social distancing.
Mm-hmm.
Really
is.
And he's like, damn it, bro. I just need friends. And everybody's like, no.
That's basically what it was. And I'm assuming maybe they were like that because maybe, I don't know, they're accustomed to being around humans. Because that park is super huge.
Yeah, I think some animals, like squirrels, pigeons, like they just get, you know, if they see like humans non-abrasive, then they're like, cool.
Maybe that's what it was. And, you know, by the time we left, maybe we were there for like an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours.
Mm.
By the time we left, there was four or five of them just randomly walking around just saying, hey.
Whole family.
And they were getting close, too. It was like probably like the distance between me and you. That's how close they got.
They were like babies or just regular skunks?
They were pretty small.
Okay.
Like their tails were pretty small. Yeah. So maybe they were babies. But yeah, I always saw them as, I always known them as nocturnal creatures.
Somebody
told me that they weren't really.
Well, they said a lot of animals in general, since COVID, are coming more into the habitat, but also looking for food and scavenging, because a lot of businesses aren't open like they used to.
I did hear about like the, what was they calling them? They were calling them mega rats.
Yes,
they were like eating each other because there's like no food outside the restaurant, so they start eating each other.
Yeah, I heard they're like attacking humans now.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It is pretty crazy.
But I guess for anybody that doesn't listen, that listens to us outside of the tri-state area, we can give them a little update of like the phase that we're currently in, maybe.
Okay.
There's a lot of restaurants open, most of them outdoor seating. There's no indoor seating.
No.
And
any ones that tried to attempt to definitely got hit with.
They got shut down, yeah. There was one in Morristown that got shut down, and one in Hoboken, I think, got shut down. And they got suspended for 3 months, I think. Their liquor license got suspended for 3 months.
Local restaurant over here, Cuban Pete's, got slapped on the wrist.
Of course they did, because I'm not even going to say it.
You still want to skip that line, don't you? Just in case you're feeling like some Ricky Ricardo's ribs.
Nah. I found better Cuban spots.
Yeah.
No shades of them, but.
Just around here. I don't know. It's like a nightclub. It's more like a nightclub vibe. I see a lot of people from different areas come around.
Yeah.
That exclusivity seems to be a thing.
I'm hoping that the French fusion restaurant that we went to doesn't get.
They got slapped too. Well, they had indoor seating.
I was going to say, I don't want them to get oversaturated with people. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Because it's a lovely idea. You know,
I drove by on the way here and it was like spilling with people on the street.
So. My mom and Andrew are there. So.
Yeah. So, what was I going to say? So we're on there. Damn, I was going to say something.
You said like where we're at, like phase wise.
Oh, I went to the spot in Palisades Park. It's like a cafe slash like little restaurant. You could grab like sushi. You could grab like shaved ice, a bunch of cakes and stuff like that.
Nice.
They have social distancing bubbles in their seating area, which that's I thought was fucking cool as hell. It's like basically like a plastic igloo.
Igloo, yeah.
And then they have like a little air conditioning unit. And it like zips open, zips closed.
You know what? That might be the... I was talking to the people at the local diner here. I said... you know, come fall, come winter. Like, you guys know what you're going to do? And they don't really do, but like, you know, have an idea. But I was thinking something like that with,
that was dope as fuck.
Eating. Yeah. Or, you know.
I thought that was a cool idea. I know some restaurants are actually preparing now because they have like the outdoor tents.
Yes.
But then that would be considered indoors, no? If everything's closed off.
And especially like, now the thing is, when we think about viruses and stuff like that, usually viruses spread less in the cold, in the sense that they can't grow. It's like a certain temperature. Like if you're exchanging a room, like hospitals aren't usually like super warm. You know what I'm saying? Like they keep at a certain temperature so like things don't spread outside of disinfecting. I don't know. It's a weird thing because we know with COVID, they said like temperatures kill it. Mm-hmm. You know, so heat kills it apparently. But we don't know how it's going to react in the cold. So.
We shall see.
Yeah.
It's going to be interesting this fall.
Definitely.
I guess you could jump in. Okay. How you been?
I took a week to myself. I rented a car. That was really nice. I went down to the beach with one of my best friends, GT, his wife, Taryn. I went with Ange. It was the most lovely weather, nice breeze. Mm-hmm. I went down to Sandy Hook.
The water's super calm, right?
Yeah, so calm. I went in, it didn't smell like trash for once, or like that overwhelming like garbage seaweed smell. Mm-hmm. I feel like the beach like definitely replenished itself. It wasn't crowded. Again, beautiful weather. I did get burned on my legs to the point I felt, yeah, basically. That was a great one.
Thank you.
And I just felt like somebody took like two, you know, very coarse pieces of sandpaper and just went at my shins.
Yeah.
It was horrible. Outside of that, I got in my my fish and chips, which I love, malt with the malt vinegar. Oh, I love that so much. I got some drinks in. I got ice cream in. I just indulged like the whole week. I was about to go to New York. Mm-hmm. But then I was like, you know what? I heard the crime rates are up. I heard it's not so fantastic at the moment. So I kind of like left that alone. Mm-hmm. But I just, I took time to catch up with friends. I've been doing my studies. You know, I've been overwhelmed with studies on the Red Komodo. That thing just like so beastly. It makes me happy. If you guys don't know, Red digital cinema cameras came out with like a little beast of a camera. It's not really out yet, but, you know, it's in testing. It's in beta, something that I like to indulge in. What else? I went to IKEA. I love IKEA. It always gives me these ideas for, like, decorating the space. I've gotten to my space where I'm like, I don't need anything else. Mm-hmm. Like, I really like my space as is. I try to keep it minimal. But that's something that, like, again, in adult life has interest me. Mm-hmm. So it brings me pleasure. I did notice, though, speaking of anxiety, when driving, almost like I notice in my life in particular, I'm so excited for the future sometimes that I'm like, I don't want to like put myself in danger on the road because I feel like so many people are like aggressive on the road, like mm-hmm. they can't die.
Yeah.
Like people pass you, they beep, like even if you're going the speed limit. I just feel like so much aggression out there. And like, I don't know, I just feel like I had to state that. It really does bring me a lot of anxiety. And I'm a good driver. Like I'm both defensive and like offensive, not offensive, on offense when driving. But yeah, it's just one of those things. Like it just makes me uneasy. So
it's my world.
I know it sucks. It's like it's like an extra burden you don't need just because everybody else is like not right.
I had an incident yesterday where I was just driving and I was in the wrong lane. So I put my signal to try to get back in the right lane. Literally for like 30 seconds fighting with this dude, and he's just like not letting me in. So I force myself in, and then I see him in the rear view sticking his middle finger out. I was like, okay,
damn. Cool.
Pull up.
One thing that did upset me is that this actually particularly has to do with somebody in your past. You're going to know who I'm talking about. But that person sent my glasses to the wrong address. Mm-hmm. So I was supposed to have two pairs of my new glasses, which are like equivalent to $600 in eyeglass wear. Lost in USPS right now. Nice. Doesn't know where it is. Nobody knows where it is. And it's not something like I can just duplicate out of nowhere because it was very particular.
Uh-huh.
And I've been on the search for that. But
so what happens in that case? Because it's not your fault. So
it's not particularly my fault. I mean, I am going to find out what I can do tomorrow. I've been in talks with I went on a crazy search because at first I'm like, I went to the post lady and I said, you know, I live at 16 Seymour. I see you often, usually use my buzzer to get in my building. She's really nice. It was actually her day off, but she still was on a route. She decided to pick it up. And she was kind enough to check. She gave me the post office number. I called them. And they said, even though you gave us our tracking and your government name, we are unable to tell you where your package was dropped off because it's not your address that it correlates with. So I checked with the optometry, and they said, I sent it to this address. And I was like, oh.
What address is that?
It's across the street from where I used to live on Montclair on Plymouth.
Oh.
I'm not going to give out the number, but I did meet this really nice old lady called Grand. She's from the South. She's 80 years old, but she's in good health, and she's the sweetest lady. She's like, you know what? I got your package in the mail, but I brought it back to the post office because I could clearly see that this was a prescription, and I really want a lot of things come my way that aren't supposed to come here, and I want to make sure that they were good.
Does she have a Southern accent?
Just a little bit, a slight Southern accent. Mm-hmm. And actually, I have a message she left me because we brought her flowers and cookies for all the kindness because I stopped at her house like four times. She's like, keep coming back to check if they dropped it off, which they never did. But then a post office said, oh, yeah, we might be rerouting it to your house like with your right address. It's just been a chase. Like I feel like I've been playing detective while the other person seems to be a little nonchalant about everything else. So I'm like,
It sounds like an episode of like CSI or something.
Yeah, I really had to. I'm still tracking it down. I'm hoping by the good graces that I do come across it because it's a lot of different, you know, prescriptions and everything. I don't want to go through it again.
Mm-hmm.
So that probably is the most negative. But I've had a great, great week or 2 weeks since we've been off air.
Mm-hmm.
And, I'm looking forward to a lot of things. I'm just really trying to stay. I'm not trying to stay. I feel like I'm optimistic. I'm just trying to be realistic with a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And for now, you know, I do like the gigs that we've been getting and stuff like that. So,
yeah, they haven't been bad.
No.
Not painstaking, at least.
No. I got Indian food in this week. It's never a bad week when I get Indian food. I tried a nice place in Jersey City. I think it was called Cuisine of India.
Mm-hmm.
The guy just opened when COVID started.
Sheesh.
So he's just been having a struggle.
Hitting the ground running.
I know. But he was really, really kind. One of the nicest owners I came across in a while. He gave us free mango lassi. You know, that's always, and it was on point. He gave us free dessert. We went in, we got chicken tikka masala, all this stuff. Mm-hmm. And it was so, so good. And then had a photo shoot for Cindy. Congratulations to Cindy on, yes, having your first child.
Yes.
Kelvin,
mm-hmm.
which is Jay's cousin.
Mm-hmm.
It was good to see everybody. I haven't seen him in a while. Pics came out fire. I'm going to show you. Or you're invited to the party. You might just see the release if you want to keep it under wraps.
I'll do that.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. I was really excited.
I always get behind the scenes shit. Let me just see it when it.
Yeah, I want to see what reaction you have, in the sense like how everybody else perceives it. You know?
Yeah.
So, just don't look in file mail because I sent them over to get printed.
I never look at file mail.
She's gonna get like a big print to like release it. She had a really cool concept, and you know, we made it happen together. So,
one more time for the one time.
Maybe that baby will come right after the shower. I think it's due soon. Yeah, it's been like 8 months.
The baby shower's on the 6th, I believe.
Yep, September 6th.
So it's an October baby. So
yeah.
Halloween baby. So nice.
We're getting good.
All right. I'm trying to correlate the colors because last time this was this.
Oh yeah.
And I was like, green means happy. Now I have to like green
switch them off. just think like if you're gonna vomit, you're green, and it's like wah, 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 you like failed for the night.
I like that. Yeah. But this one hasn't changed. Hey.
Oh man. Gets me so hyped.
So hyped. I don't have like any topics in particular to talk about today.
Okay.
So I guess we can kind of just freestyle this one.
Cool.
I was contacted by I could tell you that, and I don't know if I told you about it. Mm-hmm. I was kind of holding off on it. And I will read it to you just now. So I was contacted by a brand the other day.
Nice.
I guess it was one of those things that were just like fishing for like free work or some kind of like terribly discounted work. Let me see if I can find it. What's the name?
Shout out to everybody wants terribly discounted work.
I don't want to put them on blast.
We should create a new company that puts terribly discounted work.
But as I look for this... essentially, what they did is they contacted me a few days ago. Here it is. I'm not going to give their name, but...
Oh, check this out. Terribly discounted work. Not only is it half off, it's half-assed.
Actually, they were looking for full-ass work for half-ass money. Ass work.
They want the whole booty.
They want the whole booty for no money.
Damn.
So, basically, I was contacted by this... looks like a sportswear brand... Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Mm.
Like a sportswear brand company on Instagram saying, I don't want to give out the name. This is such and such from this company. Really like your work. Very neat. Will you be able to shoot a nice video and pictures? Video and pictures. I didn't even read that part. It just hit me right now. With our outdoor products like arm sleeves, neck gaiters. I don't even know what the neck gaiter is. Headbands, etc., with models for lifestyle images. Please let me know. Thank you.
You know what I always tell somebody? I said, listen, they reached out to you for a particular reason. They love your work. They're going to pay for your work because everybody and their mother have a camera. So
if they want to pay.
Yes.
But the gist of it was, I thanked them for the compliment. And I said, I'm always down to shoot. What's the budget you're working with?
Mm-hmm.
And she said, oh, awesome. We're just a startup. From the jump, I knew this wouldn't go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
We're just a startup and can work at $100 for 3 to 4 model shoot for our products.
Be like, congratulations in this industry. I hope you get far.
$100.
Be like, that's not how the industry works, darling. I will contact you.
With that, I thought about this. And I said, listen, I understand. I appreciate the offer, but unfortunately, that's below the minimum rate I usually shoot for.
Mm-hmm.
I felt really good saying that.
Mm-hmm.
So she was like, no problem. Sorry. Did not mean to sound that way. It's just that our budget is limited. Hope you can understand. Could you please tell me what price range you're looking for?
Mm-hmm.
So this is when I was like, at bare minimum, $100 an hour, not including the studio space or location,
mm-hmm.
and an additional fee for edits and touch-ups, depending how many are needed.
Mm-hmm.
So she replies with, so do you think you could work on my budget?
No.
And I said, unfortunately not. Sorry about that.
Where do you guys get off? Jesus.
It just makes me wonder, like, does this shit actually work?
Yes.
It probably does.
For somebody that doesn't know better, isn't serious about their business, that's why they, I don't know or why.
Doesn't know their value.
Exactly. To me, it's almost like offensive. There that really one, that you would mm-hmm. see the quality of our work and then reach out and say, I only have $100. Well, it's like... Yeah.
And the funny thing is that if I, like, looked at their page, right, and I was like,
You know how maybe I would respond? I'd be like, do you talk to your mother with that mouth?
You dirty little boy. God damn it, I lost it. Okay, so I was saying, like, if I look at their page, right, the first thing I did when they hit me up, I was look at their page, and I was like, okay, maybe if they had several hundred thousand followers or even 10,000 followers, you know what I'm saying, with mm-hmm. great engagement on their page, maybe, I don't know, maybe, just maybe, if I'm having a great day, whatever, $100, it is what it is. I definitely wouldn't do that for $100.
But you know, anyway, at the end of the day, too, mm-hmm. that they wouldn't tag you.
That's the thing.
And then another thing I've noticed, you and I have worked for people that have literally 4 point something million followers. Great engagement. You got to get paid the price that the work is, because at the end of the day, how many people are going to come to you from that type, from that particular, you got to think about you got to outweigh your options, right? Yeah. Because in a sense, it's like, we've shot for a celebrity. Mm-hmm. Celebrity even had a clothing line. How many people that follow her are going to really reach out to you for photography,
right,
versus buying that clothing line? So you mm-hmm. got to charge, because you're going to go through hell. You can't make the bills off of crossing your fingers that you're going to get exposure. So
right.
you got to charge for what you got to get done for that month to pay your bills. Let the rest slide. Like, because a lot of people try to get off easy like that. Mm-hmm. And honestly, it's like, they'll find somebody in that bracket. Mm-hmm. Trust me. Somebody's going to show up with their iPhone, and that's what they want. I'll be like, yo, I could, photos like I'll shoot you. You know what you should have told them? Mm-hmm. I'll show up, but I'll come with my iPhone. If you want to pay me more, I'll come with my professional camera. Honestly, like,
I wouldn't even shoot with my iPhone. I take really good photos with my iPhone. That.
You feel me, though? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely. And I just, that I was going to piggyback off of that. That's great that you point that out. So anybody that's out there and is in photography or videography, and somebody comes at you with, oh, we can collab, you know, I'll tag you, I'll give you exposure or whatever, definitely weigh out those options. Because mm-hmm. we thought the same. I mean, we got paid, but we got paid a lot less than we were supposed to, thinking that we're going to get, you know, clients on the back end. But
think about it. How many times did your exes say they loved you?
Where is this going?
That's all I gotta say.
So I think what he's trying to say is that you know,
ain't no promises in this world.
Basically, yeah, at the end of the day, there's no promises.
Except you get that cash.
Yeah, you could take that gamble and be like, okay, I'll take a little cut here in hopes that on the back end I'll get some exposure if they yeah. tag me or if they push me. But again, you have to weigh out those options, the pros and cons of that.
Because a lot of people, I think we mentioned it before, because I know I love shooting editorial, I love shooting fashion. There is no money in that game, because the only exposure that you do get is by being in a magazine. Mm-hmm. So if Vogue is not going to pay you, even if they want you, and if they do, they're going to pay you the minimum, mm-hmm. which is like maybe what you might be getting for a regular shoot, right? You might get $300 to $600 for the day. Mm-hmm. Okay. The models are probably getting paid more than you.
But I mentioned that to somebody the other day.
Yeah. And then, but you're getting the exposure as the photographer in the magazine. Uh-huh. And that's something that you might give up some coin for, because then you could say, hey, I've shot for this publication, blah, 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 blah. That's cool. You know what I'm saying? So like, if it's a big brand, like it's Adidas, Nike, it's Fila, like go ahead mm-hmm. all day. But if it's somebody on the come up, you know that they're putting money into their brand. Mm-hmm. They have a budget, even if they got to put on a credit card. I think to myself, when we think about all the finances we put down for what we have to shoot with or anything else, somebody's got to make that same leap for their business, whether they're asking family, hey, I need to invest in a photo shoot, this will up our product. Mm-hmm. You got to make people work. Like mm-hmm. if they say they got $100, be like, I'm sorry, maybe you can find somebody. I'll always be polite. Mm-hmm. But
that's what I was gonna say. I was definitely trying to be polite and you know, put my foot down and stick my ground, because anybody would have been like, okay, fine, I'll do it for $100, whatever.
Painstaking.
And again, what I was saying with that is, you know, if they had 100,000 followers or anything with great engagement, you may sway into taking the $100 and be like, on the back end, whatever, they might promote me, I'll get some exposure. But mm-hmm. they have like 193 followers. Like,
no.
The nerve.
At the end of the day, when you guys listen to Jay-Z track or Nas album, right? You guys are like listening to it for Nas. A lot, there's very far and few people. There's only a couple like music heads that are really going to look up the producer and everything else, or whoever was behind it, maybe the mix engineer. But that's not perception of how it goes in public, mm-hmm. right? You just care about the person you follow. Right. So you guys got to remember that in that sense. Like there's people like your friends, they applaud you for whatever you do. They don't care about who was behind the camera. Mm-hmm. So get your money's worth. Mm-hmm. You know the time, the effort, the quality, mm-hmm. the professionalism. How many years you had to study to do like touch-ups?
Still studying.
Exactly. So it
lots
never
of practice.
Exactly.
Lots of
hours. So people got to pay for that.
Mm-hmm. Actually, another positive thing that happened recently is a picture that I edited and kind of guided somebody to take it via FaceTime. Made it to the sneakers app.
Oh, fire. Mm-hmm. Oh, I saw that. That's
pretty cool.
Rosie, right?
Yeah. So somebody from Jumpman, the brand, mm-hmm. Hit her up like, hey, can you take some photos? We'll send you these sneakers, take some photos. She was like, oh, are you doing anything Thursday? I'm like, no. I mean, yeah, I'm working, but if I have to push things around, I'll push it around. And apparently the guy needed it like the following day immediately. I was like, okay, if you're going to take iPhone photos, go ahead, take iPhone photos. So we ran through some ideas, whatever. I recommended certain shots or whatever, and obviously they go with the ones that weren't very, one of the best ones.
But. Isn't that crazy? I always say mediocrity applauds mediocrity at the end of the day. I don't know. We live in that world where it's like, damn, bro.
But I think that's the vibe they were going for. I don't know.
Just like it has to look like.
Like, I think selfie? It had to be, like, a selfie or okay. some kind of iPhone photo. Because I'm looking through, like, because the sneakers app, I think, has, like, a section kind of like the Instagram Live where you, like, tap through.
Yeah.
So they have something very similar to that where it's, I forget the name of it. But basically, you're clicking through it and you see mad people taking, like, horrible pictures with the sneakers or whatever. But either way, I thought it was pretty cool.
Like Gary Vee said, you can't, unfortunately, in 2020... You can't measure quality because it's all based off of like, he'll take something with his iPhone, but since people like him, it's quality. Mm-hmm. Somebody will go like us, go over the edge doing all this crazy shit and they'll be like, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's why he capitalizes on that. Like he'll put out a podcast episode that's 3 minutes long while he's on a plane and an idea just pops into his head and he'll record it straight to his iPhone, sends it to his guys and they'll post it right back on there. Yeah. And it's just like the shittiest quality. And he knows.
Ah, man.
And he knows that shit.
Yeah.
So, but,
it's fast food generation.
It is what it is. Speaking of fast food generation, apparently there's this new streaming service called Quibi. Have you heard of it?
No, but Arthur told me about something called something live that you get paid $20 an hour. Mm-hmm. And if you do 50 hours a week, mm-hmm. you get $3,000.
Doing what?
Just talking about whatever, like something like this, mm-hmm. we could do a podcast. And if we accumulate 50 hours within the week, or just as individuals, you don't have to be a celebrity. Hmm. China's paying out of pocket. It's like a up and comer type of new live. It's going to be the new sensation.
I need more information.
I will give it to you.
Okay.
It's coming. Okay. He says it comes with contracts, everything. He says he put a couple of people on it. They already got paid.
Interesting.
Yeah, you don't have to be a celebrity. It's not like something dirty where, you guys might be, getting skimpy on live. But no, it's, you could be, talking about comic books. We could be talking about camera gear, but mm-hmm. people just watch you and then you get paid.
Interesting. Okay. We need to talk about that.
Oh, well, we will.
But Quibi is a new streaming service that's actually shot for phones. So everything's shot in portrait mode. Made for your phone and made for quick access. So like the episodes apparently are like 10 to 15 minutes.
Oh, okay.
So you can watch it this way rather than this way.
I see.
Shot like that.
Gotcha.
Which I thought was a pretty interesting concept. I think Kevin Hart has a movie on there. What else?
I see a lot of people go vertical with the cameras now.
Yeah. Which is interesting. I mean, a lot of people are on their phones anyway. Mm-hmm. I like to, what'd you call it? When I do the promo videos, I like to do it that's portrait mode. Yeah.
Would you shoot like a whole feature film?
Like that?
Yeah.
Not unless it's made for that particular app.
It would be like a cool service. Like a cool challenge. I don't know. Yeah.
We could. We definitely can. I mean, we shoot the podcast and I try to edit the promo clips. Mm-hmm. in portrait mode because it takes up more, what they call more real estate on the page.
Yes, yes.
So instead of doing the widescreen, which basically takes up like this little tiny space, you'll see more if it's like this and more exactly. compressed. So they recommend if you're posting any kind of stuff to do the 4:5 ratio, which takes up the most space on somebody's phone.
Yeah.
So little advice for people out there doing social media marketing.
That's good stuff. That's definitely good stuff.
And the, I forget the numbers, 1320 by 1080. If you're doing video, or is it the other way around? 1080 by 1320.
1320?
1080 by 1320. Yeah.
You mean 1920?
No, 1920 is 19 by 6. 19.6.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about the 4:5 ratio.
Oh, the 4:5.
Yeah. Which is 1080 by 1320, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
Yeah, man. So anybody doing videos, if you're trying to do the 4:5 ratio, there you go. You're welcome.
Ratios, man. It's kind of crazy how like certain platforms like Instagram always...
But the trick to that is, which is really fucking annoying,
mm-hmm.
if you're shooting something that is more than 1 minute long and will post onto your IGTV,
mm-hmm.
you have to edit it in 19:6 or 6:19.
Yeah, it has to be wide.
Right. Well, yeah. The long one.
Long one, but wide.
Right. Yeah. So you have to...
Widescreen is 16 by 9.
Right.
So usually if you're shooting film...
Mm-hmm.
16 by 9 ratio.
So,
but you want to do that the other vertically. Way
so, when you do it vertically, is 9 by 16,
16.
Which is.
Well, depending on depending on your resolution, if you're doing 4K, but right. usually everybody's just exporting to finalized HD.
So, you have to have your template or your workspace in that dimension or ratio, but you have to pretty much eyeball it.
Yeah,
to the 4:5 ratio, so it could fit on the page as a preview and in the largest size. Mm-hmm. But then when they jump over to the IGTV to watch the full video, it's still full, if that makes any sense. Because if you do it in the 4:5 in the preview, it will cut off certain parts of the video.
For sure, for sure. Yeah,
which makes it look a little sloppy on your page.
So. There's a lot of ratio techniques and export settings that you guys could look up on YouTube that like improve your workflow. Like I know Peter McKinnon. Definitely emphasize stuff on exporting ratios that get the most out of YouTube and all that other stuff. So depending on what you're doing, like, you know, Jay said mm-hmm. on IG and stuff, you want to fill in all of that work, you know, what is that called? Not property. What was it called?
Real estate.
Real estate.
Mm-hmm.
Cross working with too many
property, too much real estate stuff,
too much real estate stuff.
But basically, you take up the most space on somebody's phone, so when they're scrolling, they'll see this huge thing rather than this, you know, little sliver of video or photo. So,
yeah,
I try to whenever I shoot, I try to shoot, keeping that in mind. That's going to be a 4:5. So I try to shoot my subject in the exact middle, so you can be able to crop it and
yeah.
you know fit it to the 4:5 ratio. Even in video, I try to do the same thing. So yeah, man, it's a little advice for anybody that's creating some content, aiming to put it on Instagram or TikTok.
TikTok.
I think TikTok's a little better with that.
Is TikTok still a thing?
Yeah, it's still out there.
Okay.
Yeah. I think Trump is just trying to strong arm China to sell it to some New York, some US company like Google or some shit.
Okay.
But yeah, man.
Cool.
Video. I actually have to tell you to text somebody to see if we could get that locked in.
Get it popping.
We're trying to lock in one more person so we could shoot this damn video. We've had the idea for months now. We're just trying to lock in all the roles. And it's going to literally be like a few hour shoot. Like we're going to bang this shit out so quick. It's just a matter of locking in everybody that's down for the video. So we're just waiting for one more person to confirm. They confirmed, but every time I mention any dates or, hey, are you available this day? Ghosted.
For us, like music videos are like shooting stars. It happens when it's supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
But goddamn, you gotta wait a long time to.
It's so annoying.
It's all right though. Yeah. You know what? For me, it's like always with our process of music videos, just us in particular.
Mm-hmm.
It's always been like it's a waiting process, but like it's that anticipation builds. And when we do finally get a final product, it's nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. So, yeah, like I said, we're just waiting for the last roll to get locked in and we can get this damn video rolling. So hopefully we can get that to you guys by the fall, the latest. Yeah. Because our goal was to shoot
Falling two. In the fall.
Falling in the fall.
I think it works.
Yeah. It might work for like any of the other songs too, like the fall vibes.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll see.
Either way, it's going to be nice.
Yeah, either way. Where are we at? We're at 44 minutes. Yeah. Do you have any? Oh, we got flagged, by the way, for the songs that we played last time. It is what it is. We're not monetizing anything on YouTube right now anyway. So that's pretty much the only slap that you get for YouTube if you're posting any copyrighted material. So Lenny, A Natural, and OG's songs all got flagged for copyright issues.
I mean, we did get thank yous from all of them, which was really nice. Mm-hmm. I mean, artists always appreciate when they're recognized, but yeah, it's hard. Like, I feel like, you know, when you are trying to show support, you're right, you get slapped on the wrist. Mm-hmm. It sucks.
It is. I get it. Are you connected Bluetooth wise?
I am.
Yeah. I mean, I guess we plowed through the other section. What was the other section of the show? the segment of the show.
Oh, did we even mention the...
So signal check, we didn't. That's what I was saying. So signal check, what's the wave?
What's the wave? That was what's the wave.
That was what's the wave.
Just for this week.
Yeah. We didn't introduce what's the wave. So what's the wave for anybody that's new here? It's just us.
What's the wave? I want to like get a sound button. Where it's kind of like surfing music. What's the wave? Like,
I thought you were going to say like ocean waves and then like have a seagull go.
That'd be cool too.
So what's the wave is just anything that we're up to or that's, you know, current event wise. So, you know, all this stuff that we're working on / going to work on all falls into that same segment. So I guess we can move on to, unless you have anything else you want
before
to add.
We do. I know you're a movie buff, and I think that you appreciate these type of things. So I came across this meme, and I wanted to keep it for the podcast today, where it would say, okay, hear me out. This is a King of the Hill celebrity choice for if they wanted to make a movie about King of the Hill, and I thought you would appreciate this.
Wait. Who's going to play, what's his name?
Hank? I'm horrible with names, so you can name these.
Hold on,
maybe we can post this.
Who would play a good Hank?
I forget his name, but ever since he gained weight, it actually works out perfectly. But he used to be on a lot of like UPN9 shows. I think he was also in The Mummy.
Brendan Fraser?
I think so. I'm gonna show you right now. Mm-hmm. I saw these guys, I was like, this would be perfect.
It is Brendan Fraser. Yo, these are all perfect, actually. So it's Matthew McConaughey. We got Brendan Fraser. We got Woody Harrelson.
Mm-hmm.
And we got, what's his name?
Stunt Brothers.
Riley. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is perfect. I like it.
Right. I thought you would appreciate that.
This is good. I love fan casts. This is great. This is perfect.
I would definitely watch that movie.
I would watch it for this cast.
I know. It'd be so good.
Can you imagine Matthew McConaughey would kill this role?
He'd be like, you know what, man?
You know what, man?
I just want
a big
beer. I just want one
for a beer, man. The Batman trailer dropped yesterday. That shit was a fire.
I didn't watch it yet. I saw that you posted about it, but like, you know.
Super dark. I love it.
Nice.
Super aggressive, old school, like Batman just getting into the game, trying to figure himself out type of thing.
That's hot.
PTSD Batman is the best Batman.
PTSD just, Batman, yeah.
They showed that one clip. When you see the trailer, this is one clip where he's like beating the shit out of somebody. He goes, the meme is Batman when he sees a man stealing a loaf of bread to feed his family. He's like beating the shit out of the guy.
Jesus Christ. I love when the Batman series goes dark.
Yeah.
I think what they did with Joker, phenomenal. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I don't know. I wish they would do that. Like I said, I think I mentioned that a couple times on the podcast. I wish they would go darker with a lot.
Because
like the Marvel world and all that, like DC, it's a dark place.
Mm-hmm.
But it's to show how justice and prosperity prevails.
Yeah, man. So there was an event that happened this weekend. It was kind of like a virtual Comic-Con, but for like DC universes.
Nice.
So it was like a lot of DC related stuff. So they dropped the trailer for the Batman movie, Robert Pattinson. They dropped the trailer for the Justice League Snyder Cut edition.
Okay.
and a bunch of video games that are dropping, like Gotham Knights video game, which looks really cool. The Suicide Squad kills the Justice League video game.
Wow.
Yeah. So apparently, like,
so it's Team Bad.
Yeah, yeah. Team Bad versus Team Good, because Team Good was brainwashed to kill people.
That's how kind of like the basis of Mortal Kombat 11 was. Mm-hmm. And I kind of like that. Like, it starts out like the trailer is kind of like Raiden. And then I think that, who was it? Was it Kung Lao?
Kung Lao.
So Kung Lao, oh, he's the there. Hat. Yeah. Kung Lao, he's like in, if I'm not mistaken, I think that's how it starts. It's like Raiden, they're like Kung Lao, they're both evil. And he's like, blah, 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 blah. Like, I don't know. Cause like they died, but then they spared their souls. And the only way to come back was being a bad guy. And like Raiden just fucking, he's so like, no mercy. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, I kind of like, it's kind of cool sometimes, but then I was taken back, like, what the fuck is going on?
Didn't Raiden start off as a bad guy, or was he always good?
Always good. Okay. He was always, like, team leader of, what's his name?
Liu Kang.
Liu Kang. Mm-hmm. Liu Kang, and then,
Shang Tsung was the bad guy.
Shang Tsung was bad. I don't know. And then, like, Jade is bad, but, like, Jade is good in the real, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. There's a lot of crazy shit. New characters in there too. It could be RoboCop, Spawn, Joker.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Terminator. They're actually filming a Mortal Kombat movie now that I think the protagonist or the main character is Johnny Cage.
Yeah. Johnny Cage actually in Mortal Kombat 11 marries Sonya Blade and they have a daughter. Which is kind of cool. Mm-hmm. But like, it's like, yeah, there's like so much.
Jackie Cage or something like
Jackie that. Jackie Cage, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Makes you wonder, like, how old is Johnny Cage?
He's pretty old. Like, yeah, I see the grays now. It makes you feel old because you're damn, in the 90s, I was playing this video game and now we're up to like number 11 and I'm lost with the story.
I think
like,
Jax had a daughter too, no?
Yeah, Jax had a daughter as well. Her name is Jackie.
I think her name is Jackie Briggs.
Yeah, Jackie Briggs. Mm-hmm. And she's badass in the game. Like, she's actually one of my favorite characters. Cause you know how, like, you feel certain characters, like, are heavier? Like, you know, you could, like, I don't know, you can just feel they're slower. Mm-hmm. She's really fast with it. She's got, like, rockets that come out of her damn, like, you know, forearms and shit.
They were saying from her titties.
No. I wouldn't be surprised if Mortal Kombat or, like, Acclaim threw that in, though. You know?
Let me see. I like that you're back into video games. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, man. I think, like, you know, sometimes when you get rid of bullshit, you, like, you tap in back to who you are. And that's one thing, like, childhood, I was always that kid. Like, as much as I'm up to date with cameras and video gear, that's how I was with video games. Mm-hmm. And, like, everything, you know, like, toys, like, that's always how I was. Mm-hmm. And I lost that about myself because I got too...
I'm going to invite you whenever I go out to this new place that we found in Morristown. It's called the Game Vault.
Okay.
It was a bank that was remodeled into an arcade.
That's fire.
And you pay by the time that you're there.
Okay.
So let's say you pay for an hour. It's like $12 for the whole hour.
Really?
And you could play whatever you want.
No way.
No limitations, no coins.
Nothing. But how is that going to be organized?
Like, so they have a bracelet that they scan.
Yeah.
Your starting time. And then when you leave to pay, they scan it and they clock in how many hours you are. They charge you by that. Literally, the game just starts up.
That's fire. We're playing
the Simpsons game is on there. The Ninja Turtles game is on there.
All my favorites.
They have Marvel vs. Capcom.
X-Men.
They have the old school X-Men game, the side-scrolling one.
Bro.
They have a ton of pinball machines.
How much is it? How like, what did it come out to an hour?
It's like, for half an hour, it's like $8 or something like that. What? For the hour, it's like $12. Something wild, yeah.
We definitely got to do that. I miss arcade vibes. And the only thing that gave me that was like Barcade. Mm-hmm. But like this sounds Barcade's more cool. Like legit.
This is Barcade with better games minus the dive bar smell.
Oh my God, so much better.
Yeah. So I told the owner because Amy's sister knows the owner and the poor guy like opened this up when COVID hit. So
yeah.
He just reopened up and the poor guy's struggling. You know, he's trying to keep this going.
Well, so sir, I will show you some... Crazy support.
It's called Game Vault. It's dope because you walk in there and it's like a bank.
That's fire.
Like there's a room that was, I guess, like the break room.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's like a bathroom there. Wow. And it has like pinball machines up against the wall. That's pretty dope. Sick. Yeah. It's cool. It's a cool vibe.
Definitely down for that.
Yeah, man. So it's cool. So shout out to them in Morristown, Game Vault.
Yeah, definitely sounds fun.
Yeah, so is that it?
Yeah, I honestly...
Are you connected Bluetooth?
Yeah.
Because I have a song I want to play. We'll probably get flagged for it, but fuck it. We'll show love. So can you jump onto your Tidal?
I will jump on my Tidal.
Your Tidal, and I'll look up the song and I will surprise you with it.
Let me make sure. You tell me when you want me to cue it.
Okay. So I'll give it an intro. Once I find it. Damn.
This is...
You have anybody you want to shout out?
I'm kind of going blank this week. I'm going to be completely honest.
It's all right. It's all right.
I will shout out... I don't know. They don't really need a shout out, but like, I don't know. It's like when I reached out to Red Cameras, I put us on the list for the Komodo, and they were so nice about it. Like the owner of Red, he left a heart, and then he's like, Clark, can you take care of this email? So then the follow up guy was like, hey, Parlay and Jay, I wanted to let you know that blah, blah, blah. And like for a company that's that big, it's like you reaching out to the NBA during playoffs and somebody's able to reach out to you. And I think like that's just great customer service. And you feel like very, I don't know.
You feel important.
You feel important. Mm-hmm. I like that.
I did that once when I was frustrated with my basketball team. I went into like Google and I found one of the executives in the front office and I emailed him. I was like, huh? You're frustrated, you let one of these guys go, why don't you trade him for a better player? He's like, I understand your frustration, sir.
Oh wow, actually responded.
Yeah, they actually responded.
I guess that's like when you're a little kid and you write to the president and you get that fake letter back and you're like, oh my god, the president responded.
All right, so I'll intro this one. This one is a track that was dropped several weeks ago by our friend producer, super producer slash artist, the LX.
Oh,
featuring Matt Narks.
Let's do. Is it called Wave?
The Flex Wave.
Hey.
There it goes. Hey. Super talented artist out of Jersey. The LX. Super producer. He's produced a couple tracks for us. Hey. Maybe if we talk over it, we don't get flagged.
I hope so.
Either way, if we do get flagged, we'll just let them know, like, hey, we showed you some love. Hey.
Always a vibe, man.
Yeah.
I like when LX gets in his bag.
His artist bag?
Yeah.
He kills it.
I was laughing the other night because LX was lip syncing to the new Drake track with Lil Durk.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's like holding a drink topless. I'm like,
he's feeling himself.
He was feeling himself.
The whiskey vibe, the whiskey talk. Yeah. So I like this song. I like how Narks comes in. There he goes. I let him come in. At least get his vibe, his verse off. We'll continue talking over this so we don't get flagged. We'll probably still get flagged anyway. This technology.
If I'm not mistaken. Shout
out to Narks.
Yeah, I think he was a Jersey artist. And then you moved to Cali.
Cali, yeah. Hey. Keep it flipping like next tails. Birds chirping like the whole trap. Yeah. When I land, like old Matt's home. They're trying to show more love to like Jersey artists and stuff. Rather than more.
See, Jersey artists, Benatton over here knows a lot about you guys, where you're moving, what you do.
We watching.
Come on, man. We just want all mutual respect out here. We know your phone number. We know where you live.
I got
one. How much you guys know about Benatton? I want people to be like, yo.
I got one more.
Remember when Jay dropped that demo track when he first started?
Yeah. Like I want people to
do a little research.
Show us some love.
Come on, man.
I mean, we don't do this thinking that we're going to get something in return because, you know, we're just showing love. But goddamn, people.
You know what? You get hurt in this world when you actually like somebody that doesn't have an ego and you like show love, because you'll end up in a studio session, right? And you'll be like, yo, you're Matt, right? Or you're this and this. And then somebody will be like, do I know you? And you'd be like, shit, bro, like mad disrespect. Be like, Benatton been in the circuit for years.
Yeah. I mentioned this to somebody the other day, and I think I've mentioned it on the podcast. Is like, whenever I meet somebody, they don't remember me next time I see them.
It's always like that.
And then,
but then you have the face that they, oh, I think I've seen you before. Right.
And when I've never met them before, they're like, no, I've definitely met you before. I'm like, no, I'm really good with faces.
I have a great memory. Ginkgo biloba is part of my diet.
So the next one was dropped a couple of days ago. It's a Jersey Club remix to Lonnie Lux's We Go Beach. Mm. I just like the Jersey Club vibe to this. So
there's a new, what is her name? There's a Jersey Club artist. It's a female.
Kawaii Cookie.
Yes. Mm-hmm. She's been making numbers.
Because of TikTok, my friend.
Yeah. But she also had a great video that the directors did their thing.
The video was fun.
A lot of special effects and great shots.
So Lonnie Lux, We Go Beach, Jersey Club remix by Trillzal. I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name, sir.
Trillzal?
Ma'am. I don't know who you are, but
let's get it.
Trillzal remix, Jersey Club, We Go Beach, Lonnie Lux, Trillzal remix. Here we go.
Shout out Lonnie Lux.
Word. Lonnie Lux is the young lady that was on Losing Forever by Benatton. One of our most played songs.
Filipino Hawaiian with the schwa. That's her?
Mm-hmm. It's one of her songs that we just released.
Here we go, Jersey.
Here we go.
Let's go. Hey. There's something like, if you're a Jersey person, that bounce just comes in and you're just like, hey.
You can say anything, that bounce just takes you somewhere.
And you always gotta have like a cup in your hand too. Like,
you gotta do the shoulder thing. Hey.
And then you can like Wu-Tang it a little bit.
Hey. 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 So shout out to Lonnie Lux, Trillzal. This is We Go Beach Jersey Club remix. Always fun hearing a Jersey Club song. It's always fun to vibe to. So those were my two artists.
We got picked up by Lenny Harrell. He said next time that he's having a show, we are his backup dancers.
Hey.
I'm very hyped. I'm super.
I'm ready to punch the ground. I'm ready to.
I'll be like, whatever wild costume you know.
That's it. Put me in a pleather pants. Disco shoes, anything with platforms on it, I'm ready. Damn. Showing my taco meat and all.
I can just imagine me being like 7 foot in platforms and be like, we go.
Gotta take a picture of you in platform shoes just down here with a wide angle lens. Make you look extra long.
Yeah, that'd be crazy.
I'd be like, wow. I'm ready, man. I'm ready.
I had some exclusive listens today from, shout out to Lenny Harrell and A Natural. Like, we played your music couple weeks ago. I got to listen to the new joints. Mm-hmm. Oh man.
Yeah.
Some craziness about to come.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Exclusivity.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Whatever.
And shout out to Brandon Payne. Brandon Payne, you didn't drop your album yet, so I'm not going to do you dirty and drop the exclusives, but we're shooting a music video for the young gentleman. He is
right. That's
a good
on Friday, right?
Yeah, it's Friday. He's a good friend of Desmond Grant, aka Des High Def. And he has crazy music too, man. Crazy music on the way. A lot of great artists out here that don't get enough acknowledgement. So let us be your ticket to a little bit of spotlight.
Yeah, man.
That's it.
Even if it's the smallest little spotlight, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, check those people out. Check out Lonnie Lux. That's L-A-N-I-L-U-X. She was on Losing Forever, a single we dropped about a year and a half ago, almost 2 years ago. It's makes numbers on, still gets pretty good streaming numbers on all the music streaming
platforms. We did a wedding where they played that song because they liked it so much. That was fresh.
That was pretty dope.
And it sounds good on the dance floor.
It does. So check out the LX as well. good friend of ours, dropped the Flex Wave, which is a pretty dope summer song, even though you guys probably not going nowhere. Maybe play it at the beach, social distancing style.
Alex, when you don't drop something solid, I'll be scared.
Yeah.
You always solid,
man. I'm
going
to check in with you like, hey, you good?
Good?
Yeah. But yeah, shout out to them. Those are my artists for the week for the gallery. Forgot to introduce that too. Fuck.
It's okay.
We're a little rusty, guys. Sorry. Episode 41. But that is the gallery. Do you have anybody? Or
no. Like I said, I kind of blanked this week.
I got two for you, so.
Yeah. No. I mean, that's it on my end. Like I said, I'll probably have some artists next week. Mm-hmm. I've just been taking some mental...
A lot of people haven't really been dropping music anyway. So.
No. But
you know, obviously, like, the bigger artists do, but we're trying to shed light on more of the... Hey,
I'm taking
one of the less established artists, independent artists. So
I took a mental health week, and that's what I needed. Mm-hmm. And but I'll be back, and I'm gonna promote the crap out of you guys. So mm-hmm. That's it. I mean, it was a pleasant episode 41.
Yes, sir.
Once again,
you know,
just subscribe,
like, subscribe. Thank you.
Gotcha.
Like, subscribe, leave a comment, turn on the bell notification on YouTube if you haven't already. If you're watching on YouTube, just scroll down, literally press the subscribe button, turn on the little bell. Simple as that. And if you're on Apple Podcasts, make sure you take 2 seconds to rate the podcast, leave a review. If you're leaving a one, please tell us how we're doing. How we can be better. Again, any numbers or any kind of engagement, even if it's a thumbs up, a little comment, leave a little emoji, something, anything, any kind of engagement makes us look good, and it pushes up us in the algorithm so we can get in front of new eyes and new ears. And if you're on Spotify, just follow the podcast. I don't think there's a comment section or any kind of rating system on there, but if you follow us, again, it'll make us look better. And if your preference is one or the other, make sure you drop over to the opposite one and just give us those numbers. So, again, we do this because we like doing it. We're not getting paid for this. We don't have any sponsors yet. So we just do this to entertain you guys, kind of catch up with each other. And, we would appreciate you telling a friend to tell a friend. So, that's kind of where we're at today. Don't want to push this longer. We're already a little over an hour. Didn't really have many topics to talk about today. So hopefully next week we'll have something a little more interesting. Hopefully you had a good time listening to us. And if you hate us, don't hate us because they ain't us.
I mean, absolutely no sense, but whatever. I'm reaching here. Hey, at least the reach hits the stars. You know what I'm saying?
Yes!
You've been listening to the Terrible Reception Podcast with Lonnie Flonnies and Chet Michaels. That was another episode in the bag. If you're driving down 280, the Turnpike, or the Garden State, we have your back here on 98.5 Radio. And if you're driving back from the shore, make sure you wash your ass because sand gets everywhere.
I love that. All right.
It's like bipolar as fuck. You're just like snapping in and out of character.
It's like, oh shoot, I'm somebody else. With that said, we're going to hit him with the intro in the outro. One.
Can you hear it?
We don't play the social game. We are social. Power 98.5.